Subject of physics of atom, atomic nucleus. Lecture number 15, SEM, beta decade. Lecture plan. First, beta decade types, energy spectra of electrons. Second, experimental proof of the existence of neutrino. Third, elements of beta decay theory. Fourth, the concept of weak interactions. The phenomenon of beta decay consists on the fact that the nucleus with A and Z spontaneously emits leptons of the first generation, an electron positron and an electron neutrino, electron antineutrino, passing into a nucleus with the same mass number A but with the atomic number Z, one more or less. During E capture, the nucleus absorbs one of the electrons of the atomic shell, usually from the K shell closest to it, emitting neutrinos. In the literature, the term EC, electron capture, is often used for E capture. There are three types of beta decay: beta minus decay, beta plus decay, and electron capture. Formula number one. The main feature of beta decay is that it is caused by a weak interaction. Beta decay is not an intranuclear process, but an intranucleon process. A single nucleon decays in the nucleus. The nucleon transformations occurring inside the nucleus and the energy conditions of beta decay have the form. The neutrino mass is assumed to be zero. Beta minus decay, beta plus decay, EC. Formula number two. Beta decay as well as alpha decay occurs between the discrete states of the initial AZ and final AZ plus or minus 1 nuclei. Therefore, for a long time after the discovery of the phenomenon of beta decay, it was not clear why the spectra of electrons and positrons emitted from the nucleus during beta decay were continuous and not discrete, like the spectra of alpha particles. The phenomenon of beta minus decay obeys the displacement rule. Formula number 3, and is associated with electron ejection. There are a number of difficulties in the interpretation of beta minus decay. First, it was necessary to justify the origin of the electron emitted during the beta minus decay. Secondly, it was necessary to explain the continuity of the energy spectrum of the emitted electrons. Thirdly, it was necessary to understand the non-conversion of the spin for beta minus decay. First difficult, it was necessary to justify the origin of the electrons emitted during the beta minus decay. The proton-neutron structure of the nucleus excludes the possibility of the emission of an electron from the nucleus, since there are no electrons in the nucleus. The assumption that electrons do not emit from the nucleus but from the electron shell is untenable, since then the optical or X-ray radiation should be observed, which does not confirm the experiments. Second difficult, it was necessary to explain the continuity of the energy spectrum of the emitted electrons, a curve typical of all isotopes of the distribution of the beta minus particles in terms of energy is shown in figure. How then are the beta minus active nuclei, which pulses before and after decay with the completely determinate energies, can eject electrons with the energy values from zero to some maximum Emax? Is the energy spectrum of the emitted electrons continuous? It was assumed that in beta minus decay, electrons leave the nucleus with strictly defined energies, and as a result of some secondary interactions, lose some part of their energy and their initial discrete spectrum turns into a continuous one. This hypothesis was refuted by direct colorimetric experiments. Since the maximum energy, Emax, is determined by the difference in the masses of the parent and daughter nucleus, the decays with the electron energy E less than E submax proceed in violation of the law of conservation of energy. Niels Bohr tried to substantiate this violation, suggesting that the law of conservation of energy is of a statistical nature and is satisfied only on the average for a large number of elementary processes. Hence, it is clear how crucial it was to resolve this difficulty. Third difficult, it was necessary to understand the non-conservation of the spin for beta minus decay. At beta minus decay, the number of nucleons in the nucleus not change, since the mass number A does not change. So the spin of the nucleus must not change, which is equal to an integer for even A and half integer for odd A. However, the ejection of electron having a spin should change the nucleus spin by h bar divided 2 value. The last two difficulties led Wolfgang Pauli to the hypothesis in 1931 that when beta minus decay, another neutral particle, the neutrino, is emitted along with the electron. The neutrino has zero charge, spin equals 1/2 in h bar units, and zero, more precisely, less than 10 minus 4 multiplied m sub e rest mass is denoted. Subsequently, it turned out that a beta minus decay, not neutrinos, are emitted, but antineutrinos, antiparticles with respect to neutrinos, are denoted next form. The hypothesis of the existence of neutrinos allowed Enrico Fermi to create a theory of beta minus decay in 1934, which basically retained its importance even now. Also, the neutrino existence was experimentally proved more than 20 years later, in 1956. Such long searches for neutrinos are fraught with great difficulties due to the absence of electric charge and mass of neutrinos. The neutrino is the only particle not participating in either strong or electromagnetic interactions. The only kind of interactions in which neutrinos can participate in a weak interaction. Therefore, direct observation of neutrinos is very difficult. Ionizing ability of neutrinos is so small that one act of ionization in the air falls on a 500-kilometer path. The penetrating ability of neutrinos is so huge, the range of the neutrinos with energy of 1 mega electron volt is approximately 10 to 18 power meter, which makes it difficult to keep these particles in devices. Therefore, an indirect method based on the fact that the reactions, including with the participation of neutrinos, the law of conservation of momentum is used to experimentally detect neutrinos, antineutrinos. Thus, the neutrino was detected in the study of the recoil of atomic nuclei in beta minus decay. If the antineutrino is ejected together with the electron along with the electron, then the vector sum of the three pulses, the recoil nucleus, the electron and the antineutrinos, should be equal to zero. This was indeed confirmed experimentally. Direct detection of neutrinos became possible only much later, after the appearance of powerful reactors, which allow obtaining intense neutrino fluxes. Only in 1956, to Frederick Rains and Clyde Cowan, was able to prove the existence of an antineutrino in a complex experiment. antineutrinos formed in the nuclear reactor as a result of nuclear fission were recorded. Evidence for the existence of an antineutrino was the observation in the next reaction. Formula number 4. The introduction of neutrinos, antineutrinos, made it possible to explain the apparent non-conservation of spin and deal with the question of the continuity of the energy spectrum of the ejected electrons. The continuous spectrum of beta-minus particles is due to the energy distribution between the electrons and the antineutrinos. The sum of the energy is of both particles being equal to E max, E submax. In some acts of decay, antineutrinos receive a great deal of energy, in others, an electron. At the boundary point of the curve in figure, where the electron energy is equal to E submax, the entire decay energy is carried away by the electron and the antineutrino energy is equal to zero. Let us consider the question of the origin of electrons in beta-minus decay. Since the electron does not emerge from the nucleus and does not escape from the atomic shell, it has been assumed that the beta electron is produced as a result of processes occurring inside the nucleus. Since the number of nucleons in the nucleus does not change at beta-minus decay, and that increases by 1, the only possibility of simultaneous realization of these conditions in the conversion of the one of neutrons of the beta-minus active nucleus into a proton with the simultaneous formation of an electron and the escape of antineutrinos. Next reaction, formula number 5. In this process, the law of conservation of electrical charge, momentum and mass numbers are fulfilled. In addition, this transformation is energetically possible, since the rest mass of the neutron exceeds the mass of the hydrogen atom. It has proton and electron combined. The difference in the masses corresponds to an energy equal to 0.782 megaelectronvolt. Due to this energy, a spontaneous conservation of a neutron into a proton can occur. The energy is distributed between the electron and the antineutrino. If the conservation of a neutron into a proton is energetically favorable and generally possible, then a radioactive decay of free neutrons, it has neutrons outside the nucleus, should be observed. The discovery of this phenomenon will be a confirmation of the stated theory of beta-minus decay. Indeed, in 1950, radioactive decay of free neutrons was detected in high-intensity neutron fluxes arising in nuclear reactors. The energy spectrum of the electrons arising on this case corresponds to that shown in figure, and the upper bound of the electron energy E submax turned out to be equal to that calculated above, energy 0.782 megaelectronvolts. Applied literature, sources, and next slide, questions to consolidate knowledge. First question, formulate the displacement rule for beta decay. Second, explain to the difficulty of determining the origin of the electron in beta decay. Third, what is the difficulty of explaining the continuity of the electron energy spectrum during beta decay? Fourth, the problem of spin non-conservation during beta minus decay. Fifth, it is possible the decay of the free neutron. Why? So, thank you for your attention.